Welcome to Pointer Concept Code Number 7. In this particular program, I am going to show you how using pointers you can print values contained in a variable in different ways. So the first thing what I am trying to do here is, I have declared an integer variable si with the value 100 and a character ch with the initial value g. So this is si with the initial value 100 residing at address 200. This is character ch with the value g residing at address 202. I have just made a simple assumption that integer is going to be 2 bytes. Almost in most of the machine it will be 4 bytes, but this is just for conceptual understanding, so the size really does not matter. Then let's look at the next two lines. The first line says star IPTR is equal to address of SI. That means IPTR is a single pointer, and what it's doing is it contains the address of SI. So IPTR existing at address 1000 is given the address of SI. What is the address of SI? It is 200. So 200 gets copied here. Similarly, I have a char pointer CPTR, which is CPTR, okay, existing at address 1004. It is given the address of CH. What is the address of CH? It is 202. So 202 is also contained in CPTR and 200 is contained in IPTR. Then in the next line, I have a pointer to a pointer as well as a pointer to a pointer, one of the integer and one of the character type. So what I'm going to do here is, I'm going to show DIPTR with double box, DCPTR with a double box. DIPTR exists at address 1008, DCPTR exists at address 1012. Then what I am doing in the following steps is, DIPTR is containing the address of IPTR. So what is the address of IPTR? It is 1000. So 1000 is coming here. DCPTR is containing the address of CPTR. What is the address of CPTR? It is 1004. So 1004 is coming in DCPTR. So the moral of the story is very simple. If it is a single pointer, star and that IPTR will give me 100. If it is double pointer, two stars will get me to 100. That is the only important thing you need to understand. The first star will give me address 200. The second star will give me value at address 200, which happens to be 100. So let's first try to print the values in different manner. I am simply trying to print, all right? The first, I am trying to print percentage D SI. So it's going to print 100. I am trying to print percentage C CH. It's going to print G. So far, so good. Then let's look at what is the next print. What I am doing is, I am trying to print IPTR. IPTR is 200. Star IPTR value at address 200 happens to be 100. So it's printing 100. CPTR, if I just print CPTR, it will print 202. Star CPTR, value or content at 202 happens to be G. So I'm getting this G. Now let's go to the one more way of trying to print. If I print DIPTR, it will print 1000. The first star, value at address 1000. What is the value at address 1000? It is 200. So I'm getting with one star, I'm getting 200. Second star is giving me value or content at address 200. What is the value or content at address 200? It is 100. So I am getting 100 here. If I am printing DCPTR, I am printing 1004. One star, what is the value or content at 1004? The content or value at 1004 is another address 202. The next star will give me, what is the content or value at 202? It happens to be G. So I am printing G here. Now let's try to look at some more ways of printing the values of SI and S and CH. Alright. SI. If I print address of SI, it is 200. Star SI value at address 200 is 100. So first 100 is going to be printed here. Now if I print address of CH, it will print 200. Star means what is the content or value at 202? It is G. So it is printing G. So far so good. Now let's look at some few more ways. If I print address of IPTR, it will print 1000. The first star, what is the value at address 1000 or what is contained at address 1000? It is 200. The second star, what is the value or content at address 200? It is 100. So again, I'm going to have 100 going to be printed here. Now let me come to address of CPTR. Address of CPTR is 1004. Now the first star will give me what is the content at 1004. The content at 1004 happens to be address 202. The next star will tell me what is the content or value at 202. It happens to be G. Okay, so G is going to be printed. Now finally, some more twisted ways of trying to print. If I print DIPTR, address of DIPTR, what is going to print? Address of DIPTR is going to be 1008. Address of DCPTR is going to be 1012. Now, one star, address of DIPTR. Address of DIPTR is 1008. One star tells me what is the value at 1008. It is 1000. The second star tells me what is the value at 1000. It happens to be 200. The third star tells me what is the value at 200. The value at address 200 happens to be 100. Now let's go to address of DCPTR. Address of DCPTR, it will print 1012. First star will tell me what is the value or content of 1012. Value or content of 1012 is 1004. The next star will tell me what is the value or content at 1004. It is 202. The last star will tell me what is the value or content at 202. It is G. So I am getting G. So I hope this problem has completely reinforced your understanding of pointers. Do not really worry about the number of stars. Star simply means give me the content or value at that particular address. So the last star, if you are doing it correctly, will always give you a value like G or the number 100. If after the last star you are reaching an address, then you have done something wrong. So please try to look into this piece of code again and again to get a more clarity with your understanding. We'll do one more problem after this. I will call it as the confidence builder pointer problem to completely clarify your understanding of pointers.